Hey, what's up guys? This is 4YAM again, back with another Minecraft Dungeons guide. I am currently working on a sick bow or crossbow build video, which should be online by tomorrow if all goes well with the looting. I already spent 2 days farming for the desired item, guys, so please kill me already. This is getting quite insane. Anyways, right now we're gonna focus on that AFK farm, guys. You will get your hands on tons and tons of loot as well as XP and emeralds. And all this loot can be salvaged into more emeralds, so you will have plenty of it. By the way, this was discovered originally by Ilmango. He found this out during the beta, so that was already quite some time ago. He definitely deserves some credit, so shout out to him. If you like this video, definitely make sure to check out his channel as well. This will be my own version of it, with some extra additions on the official version, of course, of Minecraft Dungeons. And I will cover all the artifacts as well as armor and enchants which you are going to need for this farm. Are you guys ready to farm some XP while you're not at home? Let's get right to it. Okay, so first off, we're gonna need 3 different artifacts, guys, and all 3 of these are essential for the build. The first one is the Tasty Bone, and the Tasty Bone can be found on Creepy Crypt, Creeper Woods, and then also the Redstone Mines. I recommend you guys to speedrun Creeper Woods because this is a quite short level. It only took me 2 tries in order to get it myself. If you have the right artifacts, you will be able to speedrun this level in only a couple minutes. I think it takes 1 or 2 minutes maximum because there aren't many objectives for it. Next up, we have the Wonderful Wheat, and this one can be found at the Gekta Canyon, the Ark Haven, and then also, last but not least, the Obsidian Pinnacle right here. I am aware of the fact that you can also farm for a golem, but we're not going to need this one for this particular farm. Also, I recommend you guys to take these 2 different artifacts because having the same one twice is not going to work very well. Then for the 3rd artifact, we're gonna go to Soggy Camp, Soggy Cave, or to Fiery Forge, because this totem of regeneration will allow us to keep AFK farming. The mobs will attack us, but at the same time, when we can regenerate our HP, then we can just keep doing this for hours and hours. If you don't have the totem of regeneration yet, I recommend you guys to go to Soggy Cave and use my speedrun guide. This will allow you to get your hands on uniques every 30 seconds, and after like 40 seconds you are already out of that level and you can get this artifact very quickly. I will link it to the end of this video so you will be able to do this speedrun farm as well. Now, very important, we need some armor with certain enchantments in order to make this build work. The first and most important enchantment is Final Shout. This one allows you to drop all your artifacts when your health drops below 25%. So this will also ignore cooldowns, so if this happens more often, you won't have an issue with that. Final Shout will make sure that all 3 of your artifacts will drop down. And this will allow you to drop down your totem of healing or totem of regeneration, so you won't be able to die if you are at the right difficulty. Next up, we will take thorns in order to kill mobs that attack us while we are AFK, and this happens if our companions don't kill them before us, of course, but if they don't somehow, or if they're a little bit further away, then the thorns will deal with those lost enemies. As 3rd enchantment, you could go for some extra protection, slow mobs around you, or maybe even pull them towards you with gravity. I honestly don't recommend this one at a higher difficulty though, because many mobs will be able to hit you at the same time and outdamage your totem of regeneration. Oh, and I also forgot, guys, you could also take something like health synergy. This is speed synergy, but health synergy gives you HP when you use artifacts, which could be awesome in combination with your final shout. If you don't have any of these artifacts or missing just 1 or 2, it is possible to buy these off the trader, but the chances are quite small that you're gonna get one, so in my opinion it will be faster to speedrun for them, and it will also be a lot cheaper because buying artifacts from the trader is so damn expensive. I think it is a waste. Now for the armor, this is easily found when buying pieces off the blacksmith. Any armor type will be just fine. Just look after the final shout and thorns enchantments. As 3rd, take one of the enchantments of your choosing. And of course, if you are on a lower difficulty and only have 2 enchantment slots, then you don't have to worry about that at all. Now, for the farm, we will be doing this on pumpkin pastures, like Il Mango discovered in the beta. There is a place in the middle of the level which keeps spawning monsters if you don't follow the standard objective for this mission. We will go AFK right there with our setup, and also keep in mind that my current difficulty settings might differ from yours. As reference, I am currently on Apocalypse 6, and I'm going to do this on Adventure 6. I already have some pretty decent gear, but if this is too easy or difficult for you, just change accordingly. It looks like if you salvage items from a lower level, you will get the same amount of emeralds compared to a higher level. So don't try to overdo it and play safe. Remember, it is an AFK farm, so you don't want to die or all is lost. So, once you have arrived at Pumpkin Pastures, in order to get to the AFK farm spot, you must first get past the boat. This can either be a boat bridge or one which you can see in a canyon on the top side. After that, you should go past the big ravine where you can find a fort. This one can be easily recognized by the long wall. This is the wall where you can find the hidden rune for the secret cow level, so you probably recognize it because of that. If you go past this wall, you will cross a big field with burning houses, etc. You will simply follow your objective. You can progress to the second little area and will arrive at the place where we can set up the farm. Right now, you're gonna equip your enchanted armor and also your three artifacts that you're gonna need for this farm, and then you're gonna plant right in the middle of this little place. The mobs will start spawning right around you, and then we're gonna start to attack you as well. But this is where your artifacts come in. If you drop low HP, you will automatically use your artifacts, but right now, for the first time, of course, I'm gonna use them myself. And you can see that both the wolf and the llama will start to go berserk on the enemies. If one of them won't attack a mob that is attacking you, the mob will simply kill itself because of the thorns. Now you can go to school, work, start cooking, go to bed, or even take a day off your computer, and this will allow you to get tons and tons of items without having to do anything. And after about 30 to 45 minutes of AFKing, you can see that all this stuff has dropped on my floor. So I already have quite some emeralds around me, as well as items, which I will be able to salvage for even more emeralds. And my XP is growing slowly as well. As you can see, my level is already quite high. So XP wise, this is not the best farm for me or you, especially when you're on a super high level already. I recommend to do something on Apocalypse 6 or don't do it AFK at all. Well, I am experimenting with something new that will allow you to AFK farm on Apocalypse level 6, but I'll make a video for that in the future. So if you're interested for that one, definitely make sure to subscribe and stay tuned. Now, back at the camp, you can see that I have looted many, many items, and my emeralds are currently on 1137 after picking every single one up. So this is already a pretty nice amount of emeralds, but right now I'm going to salvage all the items which I have found on this farm. Look at that. In total, we have over 2,000 emeralds, which is really nice. Right now, you will be able to buy some new items off the blacksmith or from the trader, whatever you choose. But for artifacts, I definitely recommend to do some speedruns because they are so pricey, guys. Alright, so guys, that is pretty much everything you need to know in order to make this work correctly. Definitely make sure you have all the items needed, all the artifacts, as well as the armor enchantments, which I mentioned right here. I will go over them once again. So I have my hero's armor right here with Final Shout, and this will pop up every 8 seconds on the maximum level. Then also the thorns, which will give you a 200% damage return towards enemies, and then the cowardice. Well, right now this is not very useful, but I could always use it for another build. So guys, thanks a lot for watching. That is everything you need to know. I hope this video was useful for you. Also, don't forget to check out Il Mango for testing this out on the beta. He discovered it, so he definitely deserves some credit as well. Guys, if you were interested in another farm, definitely make sure you leave it in the comments down below. I am already working on that XP farm for the highest apocalypse difficulty, so definitely stay tuned and hit that subscribe button. Guys, I'll see you tomorrow once again with another video. Right now, it is 4 a.m. Out. See you in the next one.